Lavre. My name is AJ. I'm a comics artist from Los Angeles. I went to school in Pasadena, studied illustration, and I wrote a book called In Waves. Sure. My book is a book that deals with love, loss, and the history of surfing. It's basically two narratives intertwined. My personal history with surfing and the history of surfing in general, and a love story as well. The feedback I received from the French readers have been all different degrees of love and respect, and I've been showered with letters and gifts, and people approach me with very personal stories, and I'm just overwhelmed. I'm very, very grateful for anyone that's taken the time to read the book, and the fact that it resonates with so many people is it means a lot to me. And a good drawing to me is one that, you know, aesthetically, I can agree with the choices of the artist, or I'm surprised by a choice of an artist. I think that might be a good drawing to me, is when something is seemingly effortless, or if it seems like I've never seen anything quite like it, or if it's a rendition of something else, or an homage. There's just so many different aspects to a good drawing. It's really subjective. But personally, is what I think is a good drawing may be different from whoever else thinks. They might think it's a bad drawing. But yeah, I hope that answered your question. I find inspiration, you know, just definitely in the mundane. Just, I think, in daily life, I'm inspired by just real people and real stories and things I read. Anything I consume really is potential to be some sort of impetus to create something. There's nothing really specific. There's, you know, music kind of maybe gets me in a certain mood. But yeah, I can't think of a specific thing, but I think anything I interact with is some sort of inspiration. I think I don't read this book a lot, and when I do, there is one chapter that still surprises me, because it may have been one that I didn't particularly plan out, and it sort of the pages sort of design themselves, and that would be in the chapter where Kristen watches me and her family surf for the last time. It's impactful for me because I learned a good lesson on these pages, where I had text covering all these images, you know? And it was, what I learned from removing the text was that images can speak for themselves. Like, certain things might be redundant if you spoon feed them to a reader. They don't need to be told what they're seeing, you know? And it's also impactful because I remember it so clearly what happened. Every time I would take a wave, Kristen would be there waiting, and on the shore she was waving at me, and I'd wave back to her just so she could recognize me in the lineup of all these little black dots as the sun's going down at Blackie's in Newport. And it was such a strong memory to me, and I think when I read it, I get really nostalgic about it, but I think that would be the chapter.